Well, Michigan State's former president will soon have her day in court, and tonight the 7 investigators have obtained records that lay out what led to the criminal charges against her. 7 investigator Ross Jones is here now with those new details. Ross.
Ellen, Luenna Simon accomplished a lot in her 13 years in charge of Michigan State, but if she lied to police, as officers are claiming, that's likely all anyone will remember about her.
According to court transcripts, Simon told detectives who interviewed her last May, "I was aware that in 2014 there was a sports medicine doc who was subject to a review, but I was not aware of any of the substance of that review, the nature of the complaint, all that was learned in 2016. But detectives say she knew much more than that, citing notes and an agenda from a 2014 meeting Simon had with Paulette Granberry Russell, one of Simon's senior advisors. The meeting agenda shows Russell discussed a Title IX complaint that had been filed against a College of Osteopathic Medicine employee, in this case, Larry Nassar. And the folder that held notes from Russell's meeting with Simon? It had Nassar's name right on it, along with the notation S.A., which Russell said stood for sexual assault. It's all evidence, prosecutors say, that Simon made false statements knowingly and willfully in an effort to insulate herself and MSU from criminal and civil liability.
I'm sorry that we did not discover his crimes and remove him from the community sooner.
There are also questions tonight about whether Simon told the complete story to Congress. When she testified before a Senate subcommittee earlier this summer, she was asked about what she knew about the Nassar Title IX complaint.
I received an email from the Title IX officer saying that there was an individual in sports medicine being reviewed. My comment was play it with a straight bat.
But again, according to state police, it was much more than just an email. Simon was told Nassar's name and the nature of allegations in an in-person meeting, they say.
Nobody is above the law.
David Middleman is an attorney who represents 111 women and girls abused by Larry Nassar.
This is what happens when you have a cover-up.
Now, a source on Capitol Hill said staff today was looking into Simon's testimony from this summer and whether it was complete. Yesterday, Simon's attorney Lee Silver called the charges against her baseless and said she will be exonerated. Simon will be arraigned on Monday in Eaton County District Court. Glenda.
Still unfolding. All right, thank you so much, Ross.